King, and then Ayo. Go at Ishii, good luck, good luck, good luck then, good luck then for both teams, and then sa mga nakabet dyan, good luck sa inyo dyan, guys. And hopefully, magkaroon tayo ng isang magandang game. Ayan. At Ishii, natulog ka na ba? Of course not. What is sleep? Kuya, Kuya Raja, what is sleep? Ayan na. Wait lang, guys. Ang init. So, ayan. Hinihintay natin yung next ban ng Virtus Pro. Ayan. Looking at their drafts, of course, this is a Drow Ranger and OD on the side of NP. Like what we've watched, and then we've seen other teams na figure out na nila how to beat a Drow Strat. They're not even afraid anymore of a Drow Strat, because a Drow Strat is a hit, it's a swing or a miss. It's either you win it or you lose it, that's it. Because if you miss your timeline, wala na. You just, you know, you just lose the game, that's it. You just call it GG, because looking at this draft, I mean, possibly, you know, I've seen other teams, they transition or they were really, really farmed. Or like, siguro, malas lang talaga yung kabilang team, because even though it went late game, nahirapan sila maka-comeback. But anyways, more teams are figuring out how to counter itong Drow Strat. On the side of Virtus Pro naman, of course, sasabayan nila yung aggression dito ng NP with the Drow Strat. Of course, early to mid game, they already got heroes with Lifestealer, Sand King. It's a great hero itong against this NP draft. Eto na, last pick will be Shadow Fiend naman on the side of it, Virtus Pro. So ayan guys, naglalaki na sila lahat ng both teams. So guys, once again, Boston Major guys, Group B of the group stage. Ayan. So Team NP versus Virtus Pro. Ayan, best of 3 tayo guys. Tuloy-tuloy pa rin tayo. Sabi nga ni Kuya Nick. Ayan. Oy! Nga pala, you guys wanna do bets? Bet tayo. Contest. Sarap. Tagal ko na kasi hindi nagpapa-contest eh, kaya... nakalimutan ko. Who will win this game? NP for letter A, and then VP for letter B. Ayan. 10 minutes lang, guys. I mean, 5 minutes lang. Actually, yeah, 5 minutes lang ang timeline natin. Who will win this game? Who will win this game na? Ayan, yun na lang yung ano natin. Kasi nakalimutan ko. Tapos pala sinetap ko kanina. Masyado tayong na-excite. Sabi ni Kuya Nick. Okay, there will be a teleport cancel stun in 10 minutes. No. Possibly. Ayan, guys. So, pakilala natin yung lineup natin real quick. Pinlace in pa natin yung bets natin, ano? So, guys, on the side of VB, solo on your Ogre Magi, Ramzee on your Lifestealer, no one kay Shadow Fiend, Pasha on your Sand King, and then si Lil naman on your Ayo. On the side of NP naman, guys, Eternal Envy on your Outworld Devourer, MSS on Omni Knight, Rose on Rubik, Aoi 2000 on your Drow Ranger, and then si SVG naman will be on your Undying. Ayan, tanggalin lang natin yung sounds na nagpa-follow, and then kay DKM, thank you for the follow, kuya, welcome, welcome to my stream. So guys, ano, walang sounds, wait lang, tanggalin lang natin tong sounds real quick. Ayan na, nagsimula na guys. So, top rune will be secured on the side of NP. And then sa baba, si MSS naman on the Omni Knight secured itong bounty rune sa baba. Looking at the space of the game, so mukhang tutulungan dito ni Ogre Magi si no one in the middle lane. Because of course, for sure, si Shadow Fiend matatalo siya dito against ito ang kay OD. And ito na nga, si SVG helping middle din kasi medyo mahihirapan din dito si Eternal Envy with this Ogre ang Magi Harassment. So, guys, ang 2-2-1 ang lineup natin. Ito na, Ignite was used on no one. And then, to ginamit niya na dito yung... Kinalim niya dito yung puno on your Iron Branch para mas mahaba yung duration ng tango niya dito. So, he could sustain more in lane. Pero ito, tignan natin. In terms of last hit, medyo nangunguna dito si Eternal Envy, of course. As a Shadow Fiend, medyo mahihirapan siya dito because he doesn't have a great base damage. So, ayan. Sa top lane naman, looking at their matchup. So, this is Drow Ranger versus si Rubick naman ang magkasama. Tapos, sa VP naman, ang kasama dito ni Sand King, ni Pasha, will be si Ayo. It's an okay lineup, I guess. Kasi, I mean, Sand King, of course, pero ito, open wounds on your MSS. Pero grabe, sobrang sakit nun degen dito ni Omni Knight. Kaya medyo fairly even yung trade. Pero sa top si Rose, he will be the one taken down and take the first blood. Yun lang. So, 1-0 agad ang score natin, guys. Heavily in favoring VP with overcommitment. And, of course, sobrang yung mobility speed dito ni Nyx Assassin, ni Sand King is great. That's why they got itong first blood. Ishii, paano makikita yung points? Just simply type exclamation point, lowercase kuya, and then uppercase P. Ayan. So, if you guys are wondering anong mangyayari sa points nyo, if you guys can collect 15,000 points, pwede nyo siyang i-redeem for an item, either a bundle or an immortal. Ayan. 15,000 points lang, guys. 15,000. Pero ito, Astral on the middle lane, of course. Sobrang nakakainis to on the side of no one. I mean, OD is a really annoying mid hero. Kahit sino naman, guys. But of course, SF, he always has two camps para makakambak dito sa farm niya. So, no worries. Medyo wala pa naman yata ini-stack dito yung any teams. I mean, yung any supports ng VP. But, of course, SF is always have a comeback potential. Pero sa baba, napasuicide na rin dito sa Undying, you know. Efficiency at its finest. Sorry guys, nag-altab ako kanina. I don't know. Wala bang sounds? What do you mean walang sounds? Pero ito na, na-tether na. And then guide will be cast on your Undying to borrow strike. Ayan na. Guys, Pasha is still at high health, pero si SVG is kinda in trouble on the other side naman. Si Awi harassing, doing a lot of damage on Sand King Pasha. Pero iyon, they would just simply back off and wala namang ganun nangyayari. Pero NP, their top lane is getting really pressured. Sa baba naman, medyo okay naman yung trade-off dito ni Lifestealer and then ni Omni Knight. But I feel like medyo mag-i-scale. Mas mag-i-scale dito si Lifestealer compared kay MSS. Because I feel like si MSS, medyo magiging support siya dito. Because wala naman kasing ganong melee hero unless ito nga si Omni Knight and then si Undying para kumbaga sa purification damage. Unless ito nga mag-overextend dito. Pero ito na, grabe yung purification. But with the open wounds and heal coming from your Ayo, Lil, and he will do a lot of damage kay Omni Knight. Grabe. Nice synergy and rotation coming from Rubick zoning out ito nga si Omni Knight sa baba. So, with that rotation coming from Ayo, ito naman sa top naman will transition and try to pressure naman itong si Pasha on your Sand King. Of course, knowing that there's only one hero on that side of VP sa top, they're gonna take that momentum and let Drow Ranger take some farms and then yung MP, possibly mag-rotate na sila dito, pero ito, napa-repel na dito si MSS and he's kinda a little bit in trouble, pero grabe yung slow dito na kinukuha and then finally, purification will secure a kill, so 1-1 na ang score natin dito, so nice kill coming from your Omni Knight sa baba. Medyo miscommunication, pero grabe yung purification. But Ramzy is not even scared a little bit. Pero to si MSS, grabe na pa. Open woods, repel. Pero si Ramzy, nice feather coming from your ionized synergy. And then MSS might have underestimated itong life and then expectancy. And then finally, he will go down, guys. 2-1 ang score, grabe. Sobrang akala ko mamamatay na doon si Ramsey. He will get solo killed by an offlaner, but ayun, on the backside, Lil on your Ayo, tethering and doing the healing, and then Ramsey the damage naman on his side. So ito si Pasha, I think he might have, ayun nga, nakita nila, and ito, SVG, he's gonna be in trouble, Barrow stride. And then finally, SF, with his race, securing the kill naman. Case undying, so 3-1 ang score natin dito, VP, doing a lot of aggression. And then ito nga, napipredict nila yung possible rotation coming from VP, I mean, NP. So great stuff, pero ito, si Eternal MB with Arcane Rune Astral, and then si MSS, ito, naka-guard na siya dito, pero tether was predicted on your MSS, napa-open woods, repel, and then nice, another Astral from your OD. Sobrang guys, naka-Arcane Rune siya dito, so sobrang bilis lang ng cooldown ng Astral niya. But there's still nagagay, ito, napa-left na dito si Rose, but it's just defensive one. So, he's gonna be fine. There's no follow-up damage kasi walang mana doon si Sand King, but he has a Mango, pero ayaw niya munang gamitin. So, they feel like it's not gonna transition for a kill, pero ito na si Ayo. I think he's gonna be fine. Yeah, he has way too much health. So, 7 minutes into the game tayo, guys. Looking at last hits, nauna dito si SF. Pangalawa dito si Lifestealer. Susunod naman si OD. And then Sand King. Tapos si Drow Ranger naman on the other side. Yun lang ang masama dun, guys. Medyo, yun nga, top got a lot of pressure from etong Ogre and Ayo rotation. Pero sa bottom lane naman, Ramsey, even though he's getting a little bit pressure from Omni Knight, he's getting a decent farm compared to a Drow Ranger top. So, medyo yun lang ang pagkakaiba ng dalawang carry from both teams. Pero ito, TP coming from OD, pero si Ogre Magi still laying around. Ito sa gitna, medyo binabantayan nyo dito si SF, or they could possibly even transition for a kill kay Eternal Envy, pero ito, ginamit niya na yung Astral niya, so they know he doesn't have one. Ito na, umunta na siya solo, but Eternal Envy is just way too fast on walking, and then there's gonna be a rotation on the side of NP, pero I believe na-cancel din niya tayo. And then ito naman, si Lil Hardy transitioning sa bottom lane. Pero wala parang gano'ng nangyayari. 8 minutes into the game na tayo, guys. So, looking at Sand King. So, wala pa siyang Blink Dagger dito. So, we will not be seeing any rotation soon. I mean, they could still actually rotate. I stand corrected. Which is an Ayo, what do you call this? Relocate, yon. Kaya ito, Ogre Magi even committing. And ito ang investing sa deep wards. They already have one here on the Dire Jungle. So when NPs or Drow Ranger starts jungling, they could rotate with Ramsey plus Ayo, or Ramsey Infestate plus Ayo, di ba? So tatlong automatic, tatlong hero na agad yon. Pero current gold, yeah, 700. Yung Silence will miss though on the side of NP. Pero ito, they already decided to rotate sa bottom lane. Because they know that with Undying, they already have possibly enough sustain and pressure to take this bottom lane. And then since they know that Sand King, though he got a decent lane setup, he still cannot farm his Blink Dagger fast. So, wala pa silang ganun po ng problema. And of course, it's an F. It's an SF. You're not gonna see him rotating early phase of the game. Pero to si Eternal Envy naman sa gitna. He will be the one taken down. And a nice kill coming from VP. So, ayan. They are not done. They did take the bottom tower ng VP dito. Pero ito, sa gitna naman. They got OD and they could possibly take itong T1 tower ng NP. So, that's a bad trade on the side of NP. So, I believe, looking at this phase of the game, and then looking at this draft, NP is a little bit in trouble. Because even though that, they're trying to do their strat, medyo nagpa-fall behind dito yung mga cores nila. Which is really not supposed to happen, or they shouldn't let happen. Kasi, they have a timeline, they have a strat to keep. If they fail, etong strat na lah, it's just they're just gonna lose. Pero ito, Tether to borrow strike and then Rose will live. It will connect. Pero grabe, nice steal coming from Rose, and he will simply TP out knowing that there's no borrow strike or any cancellation coming from BP. So guys, basic Dota 101 coming from your eto na relocate. Now where he will be going? What? Okay. You guys didn't see anything. Okay. Okay. Lil, it's okay. I didn't see anything. I pretend that did not happen with that relocate setup. But yon, I believe NP saw that. Not 100% sure. Pero ito, sa gitna na nga nag-gather na nga sila. Possible smoke rotation, we'll see. Pero yun nga, they know. Or ito nga, walang relocate dito ang VP. Tignan natin for 50 more seconds. So, medyo passive gaming muna. Pero 2k gold na ang meron dito si Sand King. So, he's gonna have his Blink Dagger really soon. Impossible in this middle engagement. They could even defend this middle tower ng VP. Kasi, ito na nga. Meron na nga siyang Blink Dagger. Like what I said, guys. Meron na siyang Blink Dagger. So, I don't think that NP knows this. They might have seen etong fail relocate dito ni Sand King, but I believe they didn't see that. Pero ito yun lang, medyo nakita nilang napasmoke dun si no one, but NP is still not backing up. They have decided to do this. Eto na si Pasha. And ward was placement. Eto na, napa-epi na. Will connect only on your Omni Knight. And then defensive Astral coming from your OG. GA is even used. But Ogre Magia will be the first one to go down. And then ult will be used on your no one. So, and then it's... si OD naman will be the second one to go down. Tapos si Omni Knight also fell down. Sub on the backside naman, they got Drow Ranger. And also, si Rubik will fall down. So, that's a 4-4-1 engagement. Even though that they saw that epicenter coming from your Sand King, it was just too late para kay para sa NP to respond, because they don't really have any mobility hero to get away from that. I mean, it's great that nakuha lang nila dito si Omni Knight, but still they took a lot of damage from the side on the side of NP from ito ang sa ultimate ni Sand King, plus ito pang rekim ni no one on your Shadow Fiend. So grabe, sobrang lakas ng damage coming from BP. And then NP, yes, they did get the middle tower sa middle. Siguro medyo parang, okay guys, we just have to take this middle tower. We have to take this middle tower. And then there you go, they had to suffer four of their heroes on their side naman. So, kalungkutan gaming nga lang. Pero to relocate, borrow strike. And then Ignite is also used to fire blast. Finally, he will go down. Ito naman si OD's. Grabe, out of position siya dito. And I believe he's just trying to create some space for NP to take Roche. Pero unfortunately, with them, I mean, your OD down. And then ito nga, VP transitioning sa bottom lane already. They can't even take itong si Roshan. Naka-repel dito si Aoi, but I believe it's not gonna do anything to defend this bottom tower. So guys, NP, it's just, you know, like, they drafted this. They just, you know, top just didn't work out for them. Like, it's great that MSS got a lot of farm from the bottom lane. Nakuha din siya na marami experience, but it's not enough for an offlane. You got a 1v1 against... As an offlaner, you have to take that as advantage. I mean, I feel like they just got outdrafted hard or out-executed, out-laned, possibly, on the side of NP. They possibly didn't think that it might happen, or, like, it happened, but they just like, no, guys, we can play through it. It's okay. It's fine, you know? Like, you know what we're good at? We're just gonna play through it. Ay, hindi ba nag-online si Kuya Nick? What happened? Kuya Nick is not online? Online si Kuya Nick. What are you guys talking about? Online si Kuya Nick, guys. Online. Pero ayan na nga, guys. 15 minutes into the game tayo, guys. Real quick item check tayo. On the side of VP, kay Ogre Magi, tayo magkisimula. Grabe. Only a stick and some boots. Kay Lifestealer naman. He has face boots, Mardigan, Echo Saber, And then meron din siya dito QB, si Shadow P naman, already with a Shadow Blade Threads. And then Aquila, si Sand King naman, meron siyang Talon, already with the Blink Dagger and Staff of Wizardry, possibly going for a 4-star for Yules, we'll see. Then si Ayo naman, with Urn of Shadows and then Bottle, and then ito na nga, NP taking Roche. So, finally, something good happening on their side, but Bardo's Strike will connect two people. Silence will miss on the side of Aoi. Ito na two Rays on the side of no one will miss naman. Ito na patipi na dito si Shadow Fiend. So they would just simply back off knowing that there's an Aegis or Immortal on the side of NP. Ayan. So guys, real quick, item check tayo. Si OD, meron na siyang Bale dito. He actually invests for more damage for his team. Then meron na siyang Threads. Si Rubik naman, meron na siyang brown boots, a couple of wards, si Drow Ranger, Aegis of Immortal, and then he's gonna have his Hurricane Pike real soon. Tapos, and meron din siyang threats. Si Undying naman, with Tranquil Boots, a couple of wards. And medyo malungkot at mahirap dito mga support ng NP, but not bad. In terms of, nga, net worth nangunguna, and then experience din nangunguna dito ang VP. Though, that ito nga NP drafted this push strat on their side. They're kind of failing it with just VP's aggression in general. Cause like they're just killing people or like people or heroes on the side of NP and then boom, they take T1 tower. They will team wipe them. They even got middle tower first before they killed everyone on the side of NP. So it's really good transition for them. Basic Dota, they just have to win and kill people and then you push. You know, pero ito NP on the backside gonna wrap around and try to kill itong si Shadow Fiend plus I believe si Lifestealer sa baba. Tignan natin, are they gonna succeed? Do they even have any detection? Cause itong si Shadow Fiend already with the silver edge. Ayan na, medyo na scout dito ni SF si OD. I mean. So, pero wala silang dust doon to reveal any, itong invisible, pero ito, range TP out, guys. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, coming from your Ramsey. Basic Doto, wala naman silang pang-cancel. Possibly kung meron silang Bane doon, or Roar, or anything else that could go through. Ito ang sa rage ni Lifestealer, could possibly, yun nga, cancel the TP, but yun nga. Wala, so, easy peasy lemon squeezy. Pero ito, nice silence coming from Aoi. Defensive use naman on your Sand King. Sandstorm. And he's just gonna blink out just like that. Grabe. Blink out to the face lang. They're not even scared on the side of VP. They're just like, you know, pushing and then TPing out right in front of their face. So, medyo mahirap nga lang yon on their side. Pero ito, si SVG picking up an invisibility rune on his side, just doing some scouting. Pero ito, NP naman transitioning sa top lane na, hoping to get itong T1 tower ng VP with their Aegis of Immortal. So we'll see if VP wants to defend this. I mean, they're not even like worried a little bit. Yes, of course, NP does have Aegis of Immortal, but they're not actually winning this game. It's still heavily in favoring BP because looking at net worth, SF is still leading with itong si Lifestealer and they even take itong ancient stack ni Jaur. It's only two, but still, you know, that's a lot of gold already coming from NP, itong ancient stack nila. Pero they will transition itong sa T2 tower already ng BP. Tingnan natin if they wanna defend this, but instead, they're gonna trade for T2 middle naman ng NP. I believe that medyo pangit yung trade kasi T2 ng Dire is not really that worth compared dito sa tier 2 ng NP sa gitna or yung T2 nila sa baba. Mas importante yun because there's nothing really on the top T2. Pero ito Ramsey, rage TP out na naman. Grabe. Sobrang nakakainis yun on the side of NP. They're just getting TP'd out right in front of their face. They can't even do anything about it. Hopefully, with OD investing itong, kapag nakahex siguro siya dito, possibly they could do some cancellation, like, you know, blink or four staff or something in. Forza for anything, you know, fast kill from, but they're not even a, like a burst hero. I mean, hopefully with a Drow Ranger getting his core items mamaya, but they're not even winning this game. BP has a lot of core items more than dito nga sa NP. So, that's a little bit sad on their side naman. So, ito. Awi, ito nga napa Shadow Blade na rin siya dito. Possibly going for a Silver Edge because it's still good against ito nga sa Sand King SF or sa Life Stealer. Ayan. It's actually great. And also, syempre, malaking tulong din yun so he could position himself or possibly get away from possible pickoffs coming from VP. Pero ito, si Ramsey hiding on the trees. They could, that possibly they're planning for a relocate, pero wala na. Even NP, they're just so scared. They all gather up together. They just, you know, they think na yun nga, there's always gonna be a relocate pickoff coming from BP. So sama-sama sila, cause when that happened, unless diba, magkakasama sila. Anong position ni Awi? He's scary. Position 1, si Eternal Envy yung middle nila. Ito si Ramsey getting figured out. Pero ito, Night Silence hitting 3 heroes on the side of NP. Pero si Ramsey dito, rage and trying to kill right away itong tomb. And he will go down. And then Awi will be the first one falling down. Ramsey doing a lot of damage on your MSS. It will be the second player to go down. Automatic TP coming from Eternal Envy. But he will, it will get cancelled by Barrow Strike on your Sand King. So that's 3 heroes down on the side of NP. Guys, that's a 12-2 end score. Medyo tagilid dito ang NP. Eto, naparelocate na rin sila sa gitna. They want to get this OD Barrow Strike and then raise a couple more right clicks from no one. And he will be going down again. 4 heroes down already on the side of NP. I don't know what else they can do here, guys. Grabe. They're just falling down. They just lost their lane. I don't know how else they're gonna come back to this, honestly. Impossible, another smoke rotation. But they just way too up in net worth, guys. See, tingnan nyo. Yung both cores ng VP. And then, Sand King has more farm than your position 2 Outworld Devourer. And that says something. So, possible with this one last push coming from BP, it will be called GG. Ito na, napumasok na dito si Pasha with a Barrow Strike. But ito na, uplift dito si Life Stealer. But there's no worry, that heal purification is doing a lot of damage on Lil, on your Aya. Pero Silence wouldn't connect to anyone on the side of BP. Tignan natin, is there gonna be a follow-up Astral? But there's gonna be no follow-up. Ito na. Nice repel coming from your MSS, but they did have Barrow Strike will only connect. Ito yung kay Omni defensive Astral on your turn na MB, hindi pa tapos. Ito na use ni no one, itong Rekim niya, but there is no follow-up damage. There's a lot of stuff happening, but wala pa namamatay. Pero ito na use na dito si Rose, and the nice repel coming from SS saving the life of ng Rubik only for a second. Nice Silence though, but doesn't matter because Eternal NB will go down. Awi doing some damage to Ogre Magi 2. Stun will connect. And then finally, repel. Tignan natin. Is it gonna be a GG on the side of BP? I mean, on the side of NP. Ito si SVG. And then Rampage! Oh my gulay! Guys, grabe yung galawan. Oh god, another Rampage. Wala tayong natama sa prediction natin. 24 minutes game, guys! That is something on their side. So, guys, that's it. That's game 1 of this series. BP versus NP. Meron pa tayong game 2, so chill lang kayo dyan, guys. We're gonna play some music, and then finally, Kuya Twitch